In the wakeboard event, 20 men and 10 women lined up to do battle for 6 finals places in each division.
As chief judge at these events, I'm looking for the riders to perform to their highest possible ability. We've broken up the scoring into 3 distinct categories: composition, execution and intensity. At present, we're running 3 judges in the boat. There's a chief judge in the boat that has the final call. All the 3 scores are compilated and an average is taken of their scores.
With a backdrop of magnificent waterfront homes, they went through their repertoires for the judges. The first upset came in the women's event, when past world champion Argentina's Robbie Rendo was unfortunate not to progress. However, for the partisan crowd, 2 Australian riders, young Beck Gage and the experienced Amber Wing, both progressed with solid performances. So too did Singapore's Sasha Christian, Elke Venken from Belgium and Miku Asai from Japan. However, the standout performance in the women's preliminaries was Florida's Raimi Merritt, a frequent winner in the IWWF World Cup over recent years. When the men came out to play, Japan's Shota Tezuka was an early standout. Then Ireland's David O'Queeve, in just his 3rd World Cup appearance, dazzled the crowd with a sensational performance, easily guaranteeing a finals berth. The veteran American Andrew Adkinson was also on his game, as was his younger compatriot Steele Lafferty. But all the attention was on the current world champion and the man who has dominated for the past year, 18-year-old Australian Harley Clifford. The Brisbane native was a strong favourite, and he showed the favouritism was warranted when he went out and blitzed the field in qualifying.
If I had to put my money on it, I'd definitely say Harley's going to win because, you know, the kid's incredible. Like, he wins almost every tournament, just seems unstoppable, but at the same time, anything could happen.
I think the best way to beat Harley, and it's really simple, I mean, I've kind of got it figured out, is you convince him that the starting time is actually 2 hours after when it is. That way he doesn't show up. And I think that's probably the best way to go about beating Harley these days.
He pretty much takes first place most events, so you're battling for second and third. And
yeah, definitely. Last year I had a good season on the World Cup. I won all the events, and I mean, it's been summer back here in Australia, so I've been riding a bunch and on top of my game right now, and I feel good for this event.